So we are here today for the first conference of the UI Forum on Migration, Citizenship and Demography. It is the conference on the Lampedusa Dilemma. And Professor Philip Farke from the Migration Policy Center of the UI just gave his talk on how demography and migration can intertwine in future policies from the European Union. Professor Farke, could you please summarize your main points on this issue?
So, there are two keywords when you look at the future of the population of the European Union. One is shrinking and the other one is aging. The population of Europe has already started to stabilize, and if we consider the working age population, then shrinking has begun. It started exactly 5 years ago and it is almost imperceptible now. But aging is already very much here. The number of young active workers has started to decline at EU 28 level in 1995, so almost 20 years ago now. And the loss to be expected is much, much bigger. If we look at the projections of Eurostat, which is the European Statistical Agency, in their no migration scenario, then you will see a tremendous decrease in the number of young workers. By young workers, I mean those aged between 20 and 45. The loss in the next 20 years will be 20% of the current level, will be more than 30 million people. That loss means a reduction in the mass of recently acquired education, a loss in the skills, updated skills of people. And to that loss, you can find a number of possible responses. Responding to the predicament can be in the no-migration scenario. Let us say we don't want any more immigrants. We can say, okay, we are going to replace young people by old people. That is a possibility. But the problem is that old people on the labor market are not exactly the same as young people, in terms of education, in terms of ability to bring Europe when it wants to go, which is an increasingly technology-driven, knowledge-driven economy. And then you need the skills of the young people. So if we want to have the skills of the young people, I don't see any other solution than opening wider the doors to immigration of young people.
We see then that migration is not a threat.
Migration is usually regarded as a threat to many things, but including to our European identities. We are afraid of increasing diversity in the populations of Europe, I would say. Diversity, of course, can be a problem. If migrants are all concentrating in the same neighborhood with an ethnically homogeneous environment, then we may think that they will develop models and practices that may differ from those of the receiving societies. So integrating migrants in the real society, in the whole society, in the greater society, is a challenge. Integration is needed if we want migrants not to be a threat, I don't like the term, but not to alter our identities. But diversity has two sides. And the other side of the coin is that diversity is not only a threat. It's a tremendous opportunity. Economists are absolutely certain that diversity is an asset in economic terms. Where there is diversity at the workplace, then the firm is performing better. And this applies to a number of sectors and also at regional level. So diversity is good for our economies, is good for the sustainability of our economies, is good for the creativity of our economies. And I would say it's a bit like biodiversity, which is necessary for the environment. We need diversity. And then what we consider to be a demographic predicament because we need migrants, otherwise we are going to shrink and to age, can become an opportunity itself. We need migrants and they will bring diversity, which is good for us, including for our economies.